today, I'm doing a painting that's really from the heart, for someone special. Hopefully, I can inspire you to jump into the world, the joyful world of painting. Let's get started. So today, for my painting, we're going to be doing a happy little forest scene. Maybe get some critters in there. So we're going to use some of my all-time favorite colors. We're going with the lime green, also forest green. We're looking at a royal purple and an Indian yellow. And for the kicker, an ocean blue. See this brown here? Siamese brown? Very beautiful. It's going to make the painting just go to a whole other level. Let's get started. So, when painting, you really want to dabble up your brush with a good amount of paint. So we're going to start off right now making a happy little tree. So, let's paint that on, like so. Don't be hesitant on the paint, remember. So just remember, there are no mistakes, just happy accidents. All right, so after we got this beautiful base going, I'm gonna wash my brush. Always look for an excuse, it's my favorite part. Beautiful. So today we're gonna mix some of my lime green here with the forest green, really make that earthy color that everyone's been looking for. Really is gonna make a happy little scene. So let's get into that. I'm gonna make some beautiful branches. Oh, gorgeous. Just gorgeous. Look at them. Hopefully I'll be able to paint some little squirrels in there, forest squirrels. Some of my favorite. Beautiful. So I'm gonna clean my brush. So now I'm going to go back to this forest green for the next side to really elevate the picture. So for this one, beautiful, just the way I like it. It's a happy, happy little branch. So as you can see, kind of looks like one of my favorite letters, letter P. Let's keep going. I don't know. We'll see where this painting takes us in this wonderful little journey. The next step is going to be using my Indian yellow, and the trick is to use it to its full potential. You really want to be light with it, soft, diligent. So I'm going to mix that in there on my brush. Man, I love it. So, little spill. Whoops. Beautiful. Mix with some green, really makes it down to earth, look real and in touch with. Looks like some wheat that are in the fields. So that's what I was going for with this little piece right here, this little doodad. And to really finish off this beautiful little, whatever you call it, wheat stalk, I'm going to use a different brush. That's right, I'm using my 4x8. So I'm using this big fella. He is a happy little guy. We have painted numerous pictures together. Get them all nice and wet. So after you finish that, you want to use the bigger brush to really bring out the vast sky. That's what we're looking for. So get it on in there. Don't be hesitant. So when doing the sky, it's really crucial to know, don't dab, okay? You just want to pull. Whip. Pull. Beautiful. Beautiful. Gorgeous. Don't be shy with the paint. It's not going to bite you. To make this sky to its full potential, we're gonna make it look like a midday scene, okay? So we're gonna add some of this royal purple that I was talking about. Really pretty color, just gorgeous. Goes along with quite anything. So don't use as much, that's the trick. Ah, oh, beautiful. Look at that. Look at it mixing there. Nice and soft. Don't dab, pull, that's what I always say. I think that about does it for the sky. For this next part, I'm gonna use a different brush after I wash this one off.
Paper part.
I'm gonna use my good pals right here. For this next part, I'm gonna use my Siamese brown. Really gorgeous color, really woodsy, and brings you to the scene. It reminds me of where I grew up. Beautiful. Looking for a really circular shape. Happy little circle. Looks like one of those holes one of my happy little bird friends would stay in. Great. So, beautiful. Just gonna add a couple more details to really make the picture pop. That's what I'm looking for. Great. So, we're just about done. This picture is just about completed. Remember, it's your world. Make it any way you like it. For this last piece, we're gonna make a mountain range, one of my all-time favorites. So we're gonna mix the purple with the blue, right? To make it look like there's a shadow on the mountain. And really, it's just gonna come out great, I'm sure of it. Get a little yellow in there. All right, so you got the peaks, coming, beautiful. It's like a vast mountain. Full of little critters, I'm sure. Oh, just gorgeous. Just gorgeous. Add some finishing touches, and wow, this is looking about done. So, in conclusion, Olivia, will you go to prom with me?